Hello everyone, this is Kyle Malone from AlucardGP.com. Today we're going to talk about the payables check process in GP. The check process itself, very straightforward. One of the things that GP is very, very good at is cutting checks. So we'll look at that process today. We'll talk about some of the different options. We'll point out some of the different new features that you get with GP 2018. And we'll basically walk through the entire process from beginning to end. So let's get started. So today I'm in GP 2018 and I'm going to go ahead and get to my purchasing module. The purchasing module, of course, is where I'm going to be managing my vendors, processing transactions, and surprise, cutting my checks. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at some of my vendors, because there are a couple new options pertaining to 2018 that apply here. So first one I'll take a look at, Ace Travel. If I go to the options, if you're familiar with GP, you'll notice this is new. If not, here you are. But there's now the option for one payment per vendor or invoice. Certain situations you may find it beneficial to switch it to invoice, but by default it's set to vendor. And now when we're actually going into the process of cutting the payment batch, you'll see where there's the option to pull it from the vendor setup instead of just defining it to print one check per vendor or defining it to print one check per invoice. So new feature there with 2018, I did want to point that out very quickly. So I'm going to leave it as is, close out. All right, let's quickly go through and let's process ourselves a payable voucher. And I'm gonna go ahead and use Ace again here. We'll just make $100. And I'm gonna go ahead and post that voucher. So nothing new there. And again, that was under purchasing, transactions, transaction entry. All right, so now that I know I have vouchers on the system to be paid, let's go ahead and let's jump right into the build payment batch. So in the transactions module, you'll see there's kind of a list of windows that all reference payments, payment batches, scheduled payments, and it kind of goes in order. Well, surprise, that's kind of how we're going to start today. So we're actually going to start with this build payment batch. And then as we go through the process, we're actually going to get into the edit payment batch window, edit vendor payment, print payments, post payments. So build payment batch, and first thing I'm prompted with is the batch ID. Not a new concept here, so I am just going to go ahead and say check payment, and I will use today's date. And when I tab out of this field, do I want to add the batch? Yes, let's add. So again, just additional information for the batch itself. I will call this our monthly payment batch. The required fields here, they are going to be highlighted and in a different color. One of them is the checkbook ID. So I'm going to go ahead and select my main checking account. My posting date, check date, of course. The posting date is the date that's going to hit my general ledger. And my check date, that's going to be the date that's printed on the check. Other payment methods up here, we won't talk about them today, but just know that they are available, and we'll probably have a second, third video post covering these topics specifically, but you do have the ability to issue EFT payments out of the system, and new with GP 2018, you have the ability to build a credit card payment batch. So again, I'm going to leave it at checks, and let's go ahead and save our batch, and let's move on. Also new with 2018, and I absolutely love this feature, you can build predefined payment batches so that each time you don't go into this build payment batch window, you don't have to put in your criteria for what we're building. I can go in here and select one of the ones I've already built. I could say, give me all outstanding. So if you'll see here, this is literally just saying, give me every single vendor in the system that has an outstanding payable voucher, and let's pick them up in this build payment batch. I'm actually going to remove that though, and we will build our own batch here. The whole process with building the payment batch, you build a batch instead of going through and selecting payments one by one. So let's picture that we have, say, 100 vouchers out in the system. We don't actually want our team to go in and select those vouchers one by one. No, we want the system to build the batch for us, you know, really streamline that process of selecting those vouchers. So we have some options. So if we don't want to select all the outstanding vouchers in the system, I could click through this drop-down list here, and I could filter it on the vendor name, I could filter it on the vendor class, the payment priority. If you're not familiar with that concept, I can set certain vendors to have higher priority than others. So if I happen to not want to send out a bunch of cash at once, I can pay my top priority vendors this week, next week, pay my top priority and my second priority vendors. So there's an option in there. Some others here is we could actually pay based on the due date cutoff. So if with my vouchers I'm actually processing and I'm putting a due date in, I can say, okay, give me anything that's within 7 days of the payment due date, and let's only select those vouchers. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and filter on the class ID. I'll use the lookups here to show me my available classes. And I happen to know that I have some outstanding payable vouchers for my Australian vendors. I select my Australian class ID. If I wanted to, I could pick up multiple classes, but I'm going to leave it just at one. Go ahead and select insert. And then as I mentioned, starting this video off, there's this new field here in 2018, one payment per use vendor option. That's most likely going to be the new preferred. But we do have the ability to kind of switch it back a couple of GP versions and always print one check per vendor, always print one check per invoice for a vendor. So I'm going to leave it at use vendor option. Some other options down here is automatically apply existing unapplied. So that means if I have an invoice for $100 and I have a credit memo in the system for $10 for that same vendor, when I run through this process, it's automatically going to assign that credit memo to that invoice. So therefore, I'd only be cutting a check for the net difference. If I were to deselect this credit memo option, I would cut a check for the entire invoice amount and basically leave that credit memo out there for future use. But me, I like to have more money in my pocket now, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply this credit memo. And then some other nifty features down here is if you are printing a large batch of checks at once, you might want those checks to print out in a certain order. So say we're stuffing envelopes, you know, whatever the reason might be, let's sort the checks by date, let's sort the checks by check number. And then on the remittance itself, we can list what level of detail we're including on the remittances for this check batch. So I'm going to go ahead and say all documents. All documents would include credit memos, returns, payments, all the other stuff. If I only wanted to show them the invoices, you get it. So again, all documents. And to back up, I am selecting just a certain class. So once I have my criteria in here, which I could actually add more if I wanted to, if I wanted to put a due date cutoff, I could say, give me everything that has a due date cutoff of 4/19/18. Select insert. So again, that's going to give me everything that's open for this class of vendors and has a due date cut off before this date. But for now, I'll remove that option. All right, so I have my batch. I have my criteria for my batch. Now let's go ahead and select build batch. So you'll see up here, once the process is done, you have a batch total. If this is sitting at zero, so if you have a lot of transactions in the system and you click that build batch, and it doesn't seem like anything is really happening, just a quick little tip here. You can click up here in a Microsoft Dynamics GP, process monitor, and if the batch were still building, there would have been a little option up here that said something about select payment batch building. But you'll see I have nothing here. And then I actually noticed before I went on my tangent there that I did have a batch total. So batch total is good. Batch total means the process is complete. So next step. Let's go down to edit payment batch. Edit payment batch, that's going to list all of my outstanding transactions, and then it'll show me checkboxes for what I've actually paid. So you'll see that of all these vendors here, most likely only this one vendor was in that class that I selected, because you'll notice that the 6421 matches my batch total. So if I wanted to scroll through this particular vendor and say, okay, I know that this voucher I don't want to pay, this voucher I don't want to pay, I can do that from this window and I don't have to go back. Another little note here that goes unnoticed in many situations is there are these little columns buttons on each one of these grids. If I'm looking for additional information, so let's go ahead and just take a look at the class ID. I can now see that information in this window. So same thing over here. Right now I'm looking at the voucher number. That really doesn't mean a whole lot to me. Let's take a look at the vendor's document number instead. So that's actually going to be the invoice number. And now I have that column in there as well. All right, so then I have additional vendors here. Let's just go ahead and I'm going to pick a few others. I want to pay all the transactions for this association vendor here. I'll click down to my next vendor. I say, okay, I just want to pay a couple of these. Another few here. All right, I think I'm done. My batch total is now up to 16,000. When I'm ready to roll, I select print payments. And it brings me to the print payments window. Again, I can put a comment on this field. Depending on your template, depending on your check template, this check comment may actually flow through to the template. So when I print the checks, this information here can actually get on the check and the vendor will see it when they receive the check. So we'll give it a whirl, see if my template is set up for it. And again, I have my options that I said earlier. I'm sorting the checks by the payment number. I also have additional options in this window. I can sort it by the zip code of the vendors, name, city, all that. I'm going to leave it at the payment number. If I wanted to put my remittances on a completely separate document, which may or may not make sense, I have that ability to do that here. But I'm going to go ahead and print it all in one. You'll see that it'll print a check stub, and then on the same piece of paper will be the remittance information. If I want to take a look at my entire check batch before I hit the print button, up here is the edit list. So let's go ahead and let's print this report to the screen. So if I need some sort of approval before I print this check batch, this would most likely be the report that I would use. So I could print this out, take it to the accounting manager, whoever's in charge of actually signing off on payment batches. You know, there's also the check signing process, but if someone needs to approve before, this would be the report that I would use. And you'll see up here, again, there's my batch total. I have four different checks that I'm about to cut. All right, so I'm ready to roll. We go ahead and select print. And I will just print my checks to the screen. And should I have had check stock in the printer that was already pre-numbered, this would ultimately be my check. And then up here would have been my remittance information. And I believe I have the same information on the bottom. These templates can all be changed. These are just based on report writer reports, and you can actually go into the system and change from one report writer report to another when you're going through the check process. So right now the report that I'm actually using is called Check with Stub on Top. If I were to go in and look at my other options, I might have Check with Stub on Bottom, Check with Stub on Middle, etc. So these are my checks. I'll say that I printed. So I get to the post payments window, And there are a couple options that I have before I actually finalize this process. If I'm looking at my printout checks and I realize that I didn't print it on check stock, or I ran out of ink, or I used the wrong ink, whatever it might be, I have the ability to actually reprint that entire check batch. So I could say reprint payments. If I wanted to, I could also go back and actually set this back. So I know that I just printed 4 checks. So I'm gonna go from 6.5 back to 6.1. So I can actually reprint these checks and use the same exact check numbers that I just did. If I don't wanna do that, I just wanna continue with the next number in sequence, I'll leave it as is. So there's the ability to reprint payments. There's also the ability to void this entire batch. And then if I'm having some alignment problems with my printer, I can actually just go through this print stub alignment process and print this as many times as I want until the point where I'm sure that I'm printing correctly, at which point I could go back in and reprint my checks. So for now, I'm going to go ahead and say that my checks look good. Again, my posting date appears here. This pulls from earlier. This is a date that I'm impacting the general ledger. Good to go. I'm going to select process. I'll go ahead and print this report to the screen. And again, here's that report. It looked pretty similar to my edit checklist before. So that's it. I've completed the check payment process. So as mentioned, we are continuing to push out new content on YouTube, Facebook, our blog. So stay tuned. Please do us a favor, subscribe. Let us know what you want to hear about next, and we'll keep the content coming. But for now, that was it. Check process, pretty easy. GP's pretty good at it. There you are. Thanks, everyone.